These are super cute.
I bet Papa will share his gummy bears with
you. I've not seen eggs before. Or a bunny. They have bunny feet.
We don't need a balloon.
Two different sizes, bunny feet. Oh, three different sizes because they have little teeny ones and little bunnies. And gnomes and little bunnies. Oh, and little bunny butts. Lots and lots of blank signs. Stepping up the craft game. Hello, my dear friends. Welcome back. My string was stuck. Thank you for joining me today. I'm going to take a walk. I hope you enjoyed my footage of the deer, and I went to Dollar Tree a few days ago. Why did I go to Dollar Tree? I don't remember. Did Did I get anything? It's really silly. I was doing this. I have a Chime bank account, which they're awesome. I can't say enough good things about them. I will actually leave my referral link in the description if you're interested in joining. You'll get $100 and I will get $100, which is awesome. But they had a challenge. They have this thing called Credit Builder, and it's just like a regular credit card, debit card. It doesn't cost you anything and there's no interest, but you move money into your Credit Builder account, and then you just spend your money like you normally would, and it takes the amount that you put in there and pays off the balance every single time you use it. So it's building your credit without charging you interest or you even having to make a payment ever. So it's a really good feature. It builds up your credit, especially if you have no credit or low credit. It doesn't require a credit check. You can only spend what you put in there, so you don't have to worry about getting yourself into trouble or anything like that. But they had a challenge, and you know I love a challenge. And if you used your card 40 times between sometime in January and February 5th, you could use it 5 times a day, and you had to spend at least $1. Well, you know, I was doing the no spend challenge, so I wasn't going out very much. So it got down to the wire, and I had to go spend like $1 5 times, a day. And I ended up going to the Dollar Tree and I got a bar of soap, I think. But I was there and I was looking at the Easter stuff. They have a lot of really cool, like Easter crafty kind of stuff. They still have a really big blank area, and almost no Valentine's Day stuff came in this year. I don't know if I missed it during that week that I didn't go, but there just has not really been anything. It still looks to be trickling in, but just not very much. So, anyway, I won the challenge and I get the metal card. I don't know why I do these things. Offer me something for free and I will jump on it, even if it's something stupid. Anyway, update on my washer and dryer. I talked about that last week and I cleaned out the laundry room, but you're gonna have to wait to see that. My videos should come out next week, I think, or the end of this week. I kind of fell behind. I need to jump back on getting videos. I don't know. I stalled because I knew that was going to be a major task. And it took me 3 days to do it, but I got it done. So I'm kind of on a my mind and is like really revolting against organizing right now. So I'm going to give myself a little break. I may post some other kind of videos for a couple of episodes after I get that. Well, I've already filmed all of my laundry clean out, laundry room clean out. So you will see those coming up. It is beautiful and spotless. It's clean. I mopped and swept it. So when they get here, that's where I was going with this. We went to Home Depot. I didn't film it. I was playing Pokemon Go. It was a community day. And so I was trying to catch all of the things before time ran out, you get like 3 hours. And we went there while it was at the very end. So I was a little distracted in trying to find somebody to help me, which I did, and she was incredible. And then, trying to catch the rest of the Pokemon. But they only had like four washers that were there and ready to come home with me. And they were all about double the amount that I was wanting to spend. The set that we got, I'll put it over here. I'll show you what we got. They're super nice. Samsung. I have Samsung phone, I have Samsung tablet. I love Samsung, so I'm hoping that they do me right with the washer and dryer. But they were on sale regularly, 800 and whatever it says over here, dollars, and they were on sale for $5.98. Both the washer and the dryer were $5.98 each. So the ones that they had in stock and ready to come home with us were like $800, $900, $1,200 for just a washer and a dryer. And they weren't the ones that I was looking at. They weren't the one that I, some of them were front loaders, which I didn't really want. I like the top loaders. This one has a clear top, which I think is awesome. I've never been a fan of front loaders. I think they, they make a mess when you open them if there's still a little water, and they get stinky around the, you gotta clean all the mold out and everything. I don't want a washing machine. That's gonna make me work more to get my laundry done. So I got a top loader, and I think it's really nice. It had good reviews. Some of the reviews were ridiculous. I only ever look at the one-star reviews to see if people have a legitimate grievance with the product. And I'm gonna put some of the some of the one-star reviews that made me really giggle. Oh, some people just, I don't know. I don't know about people sometimes. But I didn't find really any that seemed legitimately like the washer was, garbage. There were some people who thought the washer was garbage just because it's more electronic than like old washers. And there were some people that said that they broke easy, but I got the 3-year extended warranty on it, so I'm not really worried about that. That cost me $90 for each one. I could have gotten the 5-year one, which would have been $135 for each one, which, eh, it is what it is. I got the 3-year. I figure a washer, lasts me 3 years or more, and I am happy. But yeah, they didn't have it in stock, so we ended up having to order it, and that can take 3 to 6 weeks. So it's bought and paid for. I have the hookup stuff in the laundry room. I have to go back and get the power cord for the dryer because I didn't know if it had three prongs or four. It has four. With all the videos that I took of that laundry room, I didn't get a close enough picture of that hookup, the plug-in, to tell whether it had three prongs or four. I was pretty sure it had four, but I couldn't remember. Anyway, I have them ordered, paid for, and when they come, they will be delivered up the stairs and hooked up for me. So I'm really thankful for that because we don't have to lug them upstairs. They had a few washers and dryers that were on clearance that we could have purchased that day that we went in there, which was Sunday. But we would have had to bring them home, lug them up the stairs with, we would have had to buy or rent a dolly, like what is that thing called? And then, get them installed and hooked up, which isn't hard. I've hooked up a washer and dryer before. on my own. I am still suffering from all of the dust that I kicked up in our apartment. I need to get a filter for our air purifier. Maybe I'll do that when I go see my kids, because they have it at the Target by them. I can order it, but I don't know. I never trust the ones that I order because sometimes people say that they, look used or whatever. So I got it at Target last time. I'll just go to Target again and grab it this time. I'll be there next month. It's not a big deal. Which I'm excited for that. I'll have a lot of video coming out. Since I'm driving myself, I can stop when I want, record what I want, I'll be playing Pokemon while I go, not while I'm driving. I'm actually gonna be sharing a lot more about that. Actually, the reason I'm in my bedroom is I'm about to put on some snow pants and take a walk. I walked across, usually when it's warm outside and I'm doing laundry at the laundry room, I will drive the laundry over and put it in the wa you know, get it started, put it in the washer. You've seen this before. I had a whole video dedicated to that. I'll link it down below. But and then I'll drive back and I'll walk back over to switch the clothes into the dryer, and then I'll drive back to get all the clothes because I'm not carrying 20 pounds, well, probably 50 pounds of clothes across the street. Yeah, not gonna happen. I did that before we got a car, actually, and it was not fun. But I did it yesterday. I wanted to use my daily incense, and I'll put a little video while I'm gonna go walking, and I'll use it while I'm out, and I'll rec screen record while I'm doing it. But yeah, I walked over there yesterday and it was sunny. It was, I think, 34, but it was windy and it was pretty miserable. And it's still really icy, so I had to be really careful walking across the parking lot. The parking lots are pretty much just solid ice. I will record a little bit when I start out and show you what the parking lot looks like and what the walking conditions are. Oh, it's really pretty outside, but it's just very icy still and still pretty cold. And with the wind, and it's windy today, it's cold. So I'm gonna put on my husband's snow pants. They're too big for me, but I don't care at this point. It's better than leggings, which, can you see? I'm wearing leggings. So yeah, that's what I'm doing today. I'm gonna record a little bit of footage while I'm out, and that'll be that. Yeah, I had to let my brain recuperate a little bit from organizing. It was just, I had too much. I do have to clean the bathroom today, so I may make that, do a recording. I'm gonna record some areas that I hate cleaning and don't do very often, because I have some and they're a little embarrassing because some of them I have not cleaned since I moved in. You already saw my cabinet by by my desk, that shelf that I have that I had not cleaned since I moved in. I also have not dusted my monitors that I work with for a long time. I have dust bunnies on my computer. I am a mess in some areas, so maybe that's what I'll do today when I get back. I'll make that video for the future, but that's what you'll have to look forward to. Seeing all of the things that I don't do regularly that I should. Another is vacuuming. I hate vacuuming, and so along my baseboards, and I don't wash my baseboards regularly either. Along my baseboards is just cat hair, so I need cat hair and dust. I need to do that. I need to clean it badly. So maybe I'll do a cleaning video instead of an organizing video and just give myself a little break from organizing for the week so I can regroup, refresh, get back into that mindset. And but right now I'm gonna treat myself to some fun in the cold and go play some Pokemon. I'm probably gonna start doing some more videos about that. If you're older, have older children, it's definitely something fun, but if even if you have younger children, like I would say maybe 6 or so, it's something fun that you can play with them, you know, as an adult, and you can battle in the game like from two different devices. You can trade with them, you can do all kinds of fun things with your kids. And you get outside and play and walk, and you like have walking goals and stuff that I haven't been really hitting because it's cold outside. So I will sometimes throw on a walking video. I like Leslie Sansone. If you're a 90s person, you know who she is. I love her. I've been watching her videos since like 1995, and she's still walking. But she has such a great spirit and energy. I just love watching her walking videos. So sometimes I'll throw one of those on and just walk because, you know, I have my watch that counts my steps, which you can also link to your Pokemon so you don't have to carry your phone around with you everywhere. But yeah, definitely a good game to play. And I'm probably going to be playing a lot more and sharing it because I think it's an amazing way to encourage yourself to get out of the house and walk and go have some fun. It also really helps my inner child work. It's something that inner child work is hard, but if you have regular like outbursts or tantrums or anything like that yourself, you probably need to work on your inner child. There's a lot of things that are really helpful, but yeah, you've got to give that inner child of yours some love and attention, and this is an amazing way to do it. So it's not only fun, but it's healing as well, and it's exercising as well. So there's my rant on why I should play this game. Plus, it's good for getting me together with my son, who he loves it. That's why I started playing it. And gives me something to do with him that's really fun. And we can, you know, share stuff. And I can become interested in something that interests him. And that's the best way to connect with your kids, is to find something that's healthy, that they enjoy, that you can also do and enjoy and connect with them over. So it's a win-win all the way around. I don't see anything bad about it. Like any game or, you know, device kind of thing, it can be time-consuming. So just, you know, don't fall prey to neglecting other things. And I guess I don't watch the news, but I guess there are people who've been hurt by doing silly things like walking into traffic. Don't do that. Pay attention to what you're doing and where you are. Don't go into any dark alleys at night trying to catch a Snorlax or something. But yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna put on these snow pants and I'm gonna head on outside. All right, I'm ready to go around. I feel like, I don't know, the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man. Hang on, let me set this on the chair and show you what I've got going on. They're not easy to walk in, but I'm not going really far. Not run into the plant. This is like all padding. They're rather stiff, but hopefully they'll keep me warm. You shall know shortly. I've got my gloves. These are amazing. These are heat holders gloves. I highly recommend them. They keep my hands nice and warm, and I have my ear warmer. I have hats, but they always pop off my head because my hair is so like fine and thin that they just fly right off. And now I'm gonna put on my muck boots that my hubby got me. Let's see if my socks fit in them. There you go. I probably look fairly ridiculous, but you know what? And you can see all of my dirt here from that's from all of the trekking in muck and snow. And I'm not cleaning it until the season is over because it's going to look like that tomorrow. It doesn't last long when I clean it. Because every time we walk in here with wet boots, it gets right back to where it was. So, yeah, not bothering. All right, I feel ridiculous, but I should be fairly warm. So let's go. Yeah, I feel actually pretty warm. All the icicles, I don't know where that's coming from. I asked the maintenance guy, he didn't know either, so I'm just going to ignore it. Can you hear the wind? The only thing that's a little bit cold is my hand. That doesn't have a glove on it. But my legs are warm, and my body is warm, so I should be okay. This is what we're dealing with still. Lots of snow. Most of it's ice though now. That's why it hasn't blown away. And here's what the parking lot looks like. Just masses of ice. And it's pretty slippery. Little meltage going on because it's sunny today. So we got a little melty bits. Luckily my pants are, or my shoes are waterproof. That's like a little lake right there. This is pretty melty. Yep. You can see the water moving there. Somebody, for some reason, decided to run across the pool cover, which I don't recommend. That seems like a really dumb and dangerous thing to do. My guess is that it was children, but I don't know. It could be grown-ups who just are not very smart. Right, well, I'm gonna go for my walk and I'll show you what I do with my little Pokemon thing there. So, all right, here we go. Started out with the temperature there. It is 19 degrees. I speeded up the footage so you didn't have to watch me going the whole time. I recorded for about 14 minutes. I'm learning the curve.
curveball at this point, so I missed quite a bit. That is my little buddy, and I'm going to feed him real quick before we head out of the complex. I needed some more Pokeballs, so I had to open a gift. And I think I had to open more than one. Yep, more than one. I got a few, so... That guy followed me the entire time, and he was still there when I got back. Turn myself in the direction that I'm actually walking. There is a Pokestop right next to my house, so that's nice. It is at the come and go. It's a lot of fun. It was so windy, I thought I was gonna blow away. Luckily, those pants were really heavy, so I didn't go very far. You can see how far I ended up walking, which isn't incredibly far. But it was really cold, so it felt a lot longer than it actually was. I'm trying to catch as many Pokemon as I can with the incense, because I'm trying to do a challenge that I catch 100 Pokemon with the incense. I think it's 100. Pretty sure it's 100. So far I've got like 10. Because that particular incense, if you're not walking, it doesn't work very well, so... So you just have to keep on keeping on, and I walked enough to hatch an egg, which is pretty awesome. I'm heading towards that gym right there, and then I'll be switching over to show you what that park looks like after I catch a few more guys. That park is literally, like, around the corner and takes me about 5 minutes when it's not super cold and, windy. I left my Gengar there and fed him so that I can get some Pokecoins. That's a good way to get 50 free Pokecoins a day. Your, Pokemon is there for 8 hours. You get coins. And you also get Stardust by feeding the other critters in the gym.
Alright, I only made it as far as the park and I am heading back home. It is freezing. My body is fine, but my hand is frozen. So, I got what I came for. I added a Pokemon. There's a gym here, as you could see from my video. Excuse me. That is what I was looking to do, and I needed to spin some Pokestops to get some Pokeballs and some gifts so I could send them out. Let me kind of show you what's going on around here. It's clearly no children. This is a really nice slope to go sledding on. You can see it's a lot deeper down there. We brought the girls
in my activity, excuse me, in my activity group here last year, just led down this little hill right here, and they had a blast. This was a sled that they were sledding down. You could see the tracks of other kids going sledding down here. It's pretty steep. Right now you could go ice skating out there. There's also, I think it's called disc golf stuff. This sign over here kind of makes me laugh. Which one is it? This one, I think. Oh yeah, here it is. This area is a detention pond. I think they meant detention. But anyway, I'm heading out for good this time. Peace out, and I'll see you later. I'm keeping my hand in my pocket because it's cold. Bye, everyone.